Hospitals are struggling to deal with keeping up with this COVID-19 surge.
Yeah, Dr. Clayton Carter is an emergency room doctor with Lexington Medical Center who has been very busy since the beginning of the pandemic. He's joining us now live in the News 19 studio to tell us how they've been doing at LexMed. And Dr. Carter, thank you so much for everything you've done during this pandemic. But explain to our viewers the shift you've seen since this Delta variant came to the scene.
Thanks for having me. The shift that we've seen since Delta has come on board is just the rate at which the prevalence in the community is continuing to climb. We went from having a very large wave just after Christmas in January to not seeing so many cases over the past several months. But over the past 2 months, as Delta has really hit the Midlands, we've seen a huge surge at Lexington in particular. Our cases are up more than 15% in the emergency department month over month, counting this year to last year.
Dr. Carter, let's talk about that. We've heard from our viewers that they have waited hours to be seen in the emergency room, not necessarily people who have COVID-related symptoms. We know this is a problem across the country. How are you all handling it at LexMed, and is it a problem at LexMed?
Sure. So we have a great staff that's been thinking through a lot of solutions to help increase our throughput and to allow us to see patients more efficiently. From the time that they arrive, we're trying to expedite their care, whether that's drawing labs while they're in the waiting room or trying to do everything that we can to expedite their imaging care or get them admitted or discharged. The struggle is the fact that COVID patients typically stay in the hospital much longer than an average inpatient stay. Whereas a normal hospitalization would take a few days, many COVID patients are staying in the hospital for 1-2 weeks or even longer in many cases. When that happens and there's no beds to move patients from the emergency department to upstairs when they're admitted, we run into a backflow of patients, and we call that holding, where many of the beds that we used to use in the emergency department to see new arrivals are now held for patients that should be upstairs admitted.
Wow. All right, let's talk about the vaccines very quickly. We know that the data has shown again and again that they're very effective. We now know Pfizer has full approval. What would you say to our News 19 viewers who are watching right now, Dr. Carter, and are still hesitant? What advice would you give them about getting vaccinated?
The vaccines are very safe and extremely effective. I've taken the vaccine myself, as have every single one of my partners that I practice emergency medicine with at Lexington. We are encouraging our family and our friends to get vaccinated that are not. If you've had COVID in the past, that does not disqualify you from getting the vaccine. It's still very important that if you are able and eligible, that you go and get vaccinated. If you have specific questions about the vaccine, your personal physician would be more than happy to discuss those questions and concerns with you so that we can help get each other vaccinated and help get rid of this huge wave that's currently facing the Midlands.
I want to circle back on something you said just a moment ago. If you've already had COVID, that doesn't mean you don't still need to get vaccinated. Can we talk about how this Delta variant is different than the first wave of COVID?
Sure, yes. So with Delta, we see that it tends to be affecting a much younger patient population than the original or the Alpha variants were that came through the Midlands before.
Wow.
There are many hospitalized patients now that don't fit the exact picture of what we were told an admitted COVID patient should look like a year ago. So many people think that won't happen to me. I'm in my 30s. I'm healthy. I don't need the vaccine. That's for somebody with chronic medical issues or somebody much older than myself. And again, that's just not the case. We urge that if you're eligible for vaccination, that you get vaccinated.
So much to think about and worry about with the Delta variant. Let me ask you this. Even if we're vaccinated now, we know that we can still perhaps get the virus. Darcy and I are both vaccinated. We have been for months. So even in people like us, what symptoms should we be looking for in ourselves or in our children that we could perhaps have the virus even though we're vaccinated?
Sure. The vaccines, while they're not 100% effective at preventing COVID from becoming symptomatic, they are still highly effective against that. People that do develop symptoms, whether they've been vaccinated or not, typically will present with flu-like symptoms, commonly beginning with a fever, headache, sore throat, congestion, cough, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. body aches, loss of taste and smell, those typically come a little bit later.
So here's something that we've heard happening across the country. People get sick, they get to the hospital, and then they beg the physicians and the healthcare workers there for the vaccine because they didn't believe it was real. Talk to me about the frustration and the fact that there's not much you can do at that point.
Yeah, I appreciate that question very much. I would say in my own experience, about half the patients that I'm placing for admission that are not currently vaccinated are asking for the vaccine as we are getting them admitted. And as you said, at that point, it's just too late for the vaccine to work, for it to help your body to produce antibodies to prevent this from becoming a more serious infection. So the time to do that is now. An ounce of prevention is truly worth a pound of cure here.
And if somebody does have symptoms at home, when do they know that they should go to the hospital? And when do you say, okay, I can take care of this at home by myself?
Sure. So we do encourage folks that are developing symptoms to get tested. Whether or not that means they need to come to the hospital is a different story. People that should seek care at an emergency department or an urgent care are people that are starting to run into feelings that they are becoming short of breath, that they're having some significant chest pain, that they are experiencing vomiting and diarrhea to a degree where they are becoming dehydrated.
Dr. Carter, you've been a physician for a long time. Are you tired yet?
Certainly, the beauty of emergency medicine is being able to have the most interesting 5 minutes of everybody else's job. Whereas lately, it feels like I'm a COVID physician first and getting to practice emergency medicine on the side. We certainly all miss the way that things were before the pandemic, and it's no different practicing medicine as it is for our school teachers or anybody else that is affected by this.
All right, Dr. Clayton Carter from Lexington Medical Center, thank you for being with us. Dr. Carter is going to stick around with us for the second half hour of Friends at 5. If you have a specific question you would like us to ask the expert, you can always shoot us a text message, 803-776-9508.